Mallory, thank you very much. Well, police in Boston say they have made a major break in the case of the man known as the Boston Strangler.
Albert Desalvo was arrested but never tried in the deaths of 11 women almost 50 years ago. WMTW News 8's Thema Ponton live in our studio with the new developments in this case, including reaction from Desalvo's attorney who lives here in Maine. Good morning, Thema.
Well, good morning, Megan and Aaron. It was nearly 50 years ago that Mary Sullivan was found dead in her apartment. Well, now Boston police say they have DNA evidence linking longtime suspect Albert Desalvo to the crime. Now, police say the DNA is off a water bottle that belonged to Desalvo's nephew, proving that a Desalvo family member committed Sullivan's murder. Now, Desalvo was arrested in 1967 in connection to the case and even confessed to being the Boston Strangler, but he was never tried. Desalvo was sentenced to life in prison on separate assault charges, but he was killed in prison in 1973. Attorney F. Lee Bailey heard Desalvo's confession and later represented him. He believes Desalvo is guilty, but hopes that this new evidence brings closure to the case.
Because Albert Desalvo was never adjudicated by a court to be the strangler, news media and others have kept the story coming alive and churning and reinventing itself for 50 years now that I've been watching. I think that today's results will put a damper on that, and gradually the case will go away, at least from the kinds of re-examinations that have been frequent.
Now, Desalvo did recant his confession before his death. Police believe the Boston Strangler killed 11 women between 1962 and 1964. Mary Sullivan was the last victim. In the studio, Thema Ponton, WMTW News 8.